So some time back, I did an unboxing of 5 different models of true wireless earbuds recently released by SonicGear, all right? If you want to check out that unboxing to see what comes with each of the products, I'll put a link to that in the video description below. So I've had about close to 2 weeks to test out every single one of these true wireless earbuds, and I'm going to review all of them. I'll give my observations of all 5 of them in one review. So we're going to go through them very quickly so as to not make this video too long. And let's start straight with the first one and also the cheapest one, the Earpumps TWS one. Now, first of all, I have to say for $30, it definitely punches above its weight. In terms of build quality, I would say it's pretty good. Now, things like audio quality, it's very easy to criticize something until you realize that, yeah, again, it only costs $29.90. So I would say in this particular case, you kind of get what you pay for. It is not the best, not by far, okay? It is definitely below par for me, and I'm quite particular about audio. But then again, there are a lot of features that you get in these earbuds that you don't get in other earbuds at the same price. Now, first of all, you actually get Google Assistant integration, which is amazing for earbuds of this price. And actually, you get Google Assistant integration throughout all the different models of the Earpump series. And yeah, even on this one, you actually get Google integration. You get touch controls, which is pretty cool. Now, in terms of fit, I would say, like, I'm not a fan of this design. It doesn't fit really well. However, for this particular model, it comes with sort of like a silicone wing to help fit, secure it to your ear. And I think that's a really good idea. And it definitely helps. But once you got the silicone ear wing on, you can't put it in the case without taking it off again. Okay, first up, this is a recording of the SonicGear Earpump TWS1. Testing 1, 2, 3. So yeah, that was a very quick recording testing out the microphone from this. And I would say for the price, it's okay. At this price, I would say $29.90 again, it does what it does pretty well, and you definitely get what you pay for. There's nothing in this that I would say is subpar even for the price. Even the battery life, okay. So SonicGear says you get about 6 hours of battery life with the battery in the earbuds, including the case, all right? For me, however, at full volume, I got closer to just below 5 hours. But again, that's at full volume, so I'm not quite sure what volume they rated at 6 hours. But even at full volume, I would say don't play it at full volume. Put it down below, because maybe 70 or 80%, because anything above that, you get a bit of distortion. All right, and now on to the next one. This is the Earpump TWS2. Now, this has a whole different design. This does not follow the AirPods, obviously. These are your more regular TWS designs or true wireless earbud designs. I would have to say of all of them, like, this has to be the smallest, the cushion or whatever you call it, the ear tips, or the smallest one I have ever seen. Okay, now these ones are about $10. They cost about $10 more. So it comes in at $39.90. Now, in terms of audio quality, I would say it's kind of the same. So what I would say is you pay $10 more, you get the same quality, well, to me, in terms of audio quality. However, you get a better fit. It's smaller. And for me personally, I would prefer this design anyway. So if you're looking for a cheap pair of earbuds and your budget is around $40, then I would say this is a good one. This is a recording using the SonicGear Earpump TWS2, testing 1, 2, 3. So you just heard another recording with the microphone from the TWS2. Again, passable, nothing great, not particularly bad either. The case is pretty good as well. I would say it's not bad. I got about close to 6 hours of battery life. And one thing I find really weird, so this has a USB Type-C connector, which is weird because it's the second cheapest in the line. And you will realize that only this and the most expensive later on, which I'll go through later, has a USB Type-C. The rest of them are all micro USB. I'm not quite sure why. But overall, this one, I would say, in terms of this sort of design for true wireless earbuds, this is not bad. Oh, and one thing I forgot to mention. So both the TWS1 and the TWS2, this one, they both come in white or black, so you can choose between these two colors. Now, when it comes to colors, the next model actually gives you 4, and I would say really nice colors as well. I am talking about the Earpump TWS 3 Plus. So I have two colors here. I've got the blue, which is sort of like a dark blue, and this red that I would say maybe closer to maroon. Now, these two colors are really nice. It also comes in a white and a black, so you get four colors to choose from. Now, the weird thing is you get a big jump in price. So the cheapest was $29.90. The next one was $39.90 for the TWS2. This one jumps up to $79.90 Singapore dollars. So it's $80. So with that price, I'm going to be a bit less forgiving in terms of the audio quality and all that. So I'm just going to hold one for now. But like I said, it comes in four colors. So the TWS 3 Plus follows the same design as the TWS 1. So it's the pseudo AirPod design, which would make you think that maybe it sounds the same as the TWS 1. Actually, no. Surprisingly, the audio quality is a lot better. So at that price, $79.90, I would say it's okay. So if you are a fan of this sort of design, I would say the quality is good. So you might want to go for this. However, do note you do not get that same silicon earwing that you do with the TWS1. Now again, like I said, I'm a fan of the blue and the red, or maybe maroon. I really like the colors. It's very unique. I haven't seen anything else in that color. And it sort of gives the impression that it's a really good quality build. And I would say it's okay. It's pretty good quality. At $79.90, I would say it's okay in terms of the audio quality. Mic quality, let's hear the recording. This is a recording using the SonicGear earpump TWS 3 Plus. Testing 1, 2, 3. So yeah, you're definitely getting a bit better. You know, as we progress, we're getting better mic quality. I would say this one has a bit more body, a bit more clarity as well. So I would say it's pretty good. I mean, which one you want to get really depends on what your priorities are. You get the same touch controls that you get in the TWS1, you get the same Google integration, and you get 6 hours of battery life at about 50% volume. I played it at full volume. I got like just below 5 hours. So, and of course, like I said, it's not just 5 hours with the earbuds, it's the earbuds plus the case. So the big question, is it really worth the jump from $29.39 and now $79? I would say it depends on your priorities. If you are the kind of person that is more about the functionality, you like it being wireless, you like the touch controls, you like the Google integration, which is fantastic. Audio quality is not a priority, and for some people that's the case, then I would say maybe just get the TWS 1 or 2. But if audio quality is important, and that's really kind of your budget, then this is a great bet. All right, and now we're at the second most expensive one. This is the SonicGear earpump TWS 5 Pro. Okay, so this particular one actually surprised me a bit. The audio quality was better than I expected, even at $89.90 Singapore dollars. I was quite impressed with the audio quality. It's quite clear. Although I have to say, same problem with the TWS1. You get a bit of distortion, you play at full volume. So maybe bring it down a notch, 70-80% volume. The audio quality is actually quite good. And of course, with this seal, it's great. It gives you a much better seal. I think that also, you know, attributes to the much better audio quality. I think this is the best design that they have so far.
This is a recording using the SonicGear earpump TWS 5 Pro. Testing 1, 2, 3.
Okay, and you heard the audio quality again. So it's pretty good, I would say. This kind of ticks all the boxes. So you get wireless touch controls, you get Google integration, you get okay, pretty good audio quality, you get good mic quality, and at $89.90 Singapore dollars, I would say it's fair value. So right now, I would say it's pretty good. The casing is a bit chunkier than the rest, so it looks like this, but that's really okay. Now, battery life, so it claims 8 hours this time, but again, at 50% volume, for me, it lasted six and a half hours at full volume. Okay, and last but not least, all right, so we've come to this one. So this is the SonicGear earpump TWS7 Hyper Bass. Okay, now this one sort of confused me a bit. Like, if you saw the unboxing, I said that when I saw the design on the box, I thought it looked like a CG rendering of, you know, the earbuds that sort of open up and shows the different components inside, like a lot of these ads, but no, it is actually the design of the earbuds itself. Now, audio quality wise, I would say it's good. The best out of the lot, definitely. I did notice one thing when I play music. For some weird reason, it does have a bit more reverb than I know the song actually has. So that's confusing. I'm not quite sure why. But in terms of audio quality, definitely the best out of the lot.
Okay, and this is a recording with the earpump TWS7 Hyper Bass. Testing 1, 2, 3.
Okay, mic quality as well. I in my opinion, the best out of the lot, really good. So at $109 Singapore dollars, this is the most expensive. you would expect it to be the best. So yeah, it is still the best. And even though it's earbuds, you don't have that stick at the bottom, you still get the same touch controls. Again, you get Google integration, and good job, SonicGear. I think that's really what's going to set you apart from the other earbuds of this range, because none of them that I know of have Google integration. So really good job in adding Google integration into that. My only issue with this is that I find that it's a little too big. When you put it in your ear, it kind of sticks out quite a bit. Like even from here, straight on, you can kind of see it sticks out quite a bit. However, it does have a good seal and it's quite secure, surprisingly secure. I thought that, you know, it being a little heavy and sticking out a bit, if I were to run a bit, it would fall off. And surprisingly, it didn't. So that was a good point. But at $109, I would say it's fair value, not fantastic value. But I would say the audio quality is a big draw to these earbuds. Okay, and battery life. Again, the best battery life out of the lot. It claims 8 hours battery life and it doesn't say 50% 8 hours, it just says 8 hours. At full volume, I got about 7.5. So very, very close to the 8 hours. So good job on that. One thing I have to say though, it also has the biggest case out of the lot. It's quite narrow, so that's good. But other than that, it's quite big, so you might want to take note. And of course, one good thing is that it has Type-C again, which is a big, big deal for me. I honestly am quite sick and tired of micro USB. So good job on the Type-C. So yeah, that's about all five models. And by the way, the TWS7 also comes in white and black. But yeah, overall, I think these are SonicGear's first foray into the true wireless earbuds. And for first attempt, I would say fantastic job. I think the big key for me really is getting Google Assistant integration in all of these, from the cheapest to the most expensive. That's a great thing to have. And I think that will be a big draw for a lot of people. It is a big draw for me, definitely. Now the big question here, so I've mentioned the prices for all of them, and I'll put all the prices down here again. So if you were to ask me which is my favorite, now surprisingly, I was gonna say that, you know, the TWS7, because the most expensive, was gonna be my favorite. I actually think that the TWS5, the black ones that I showed earlier, I think that really right now might be the best value for money. I would have gone for the 3 Plus, but I don't like that design. I said again, the TWS5 is kind of similar, but it still has silicone ear tips that, you know, keeps it secure, gives you good seal from the outside environment. So my pick actually is the TWS5. Yours may vary, you might not like the design, but I would say in terms of audio quality, definitely the TWS7 has better audio quality. Now, is there anything I don't like about any of them? I mean, there are five different products. I don't have a particular issue with any of them. I will say that I find it a bit weird that the naming convention for these are a bit inconsistent. So you got a TWS1, you got a TWS2, then you got a TWS3 Plus, but there's no TWS3. And then you got the TWS5 Pro, but there's no TWS5. So I'm not quite sure why they added the Pro and the Plus, but that's not a big deal at all. I just find it weird. But all in all, I have to say, SonicGear, good job on these models. And if this is a first attempt, I can't wait to see what you come up with next. All right, so that about wraps up my review of all these SonicGear earbuds. Now, of course, I will put the links to all of them if you want to purchase them down below. But thank you guys so much for watching. Now, if you like this video, you know what to do, and I would love it if you would subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to receive notifications on our next video. I'm JP, and I'll see you real soon.